Okay, I'm getting a feeling we're gonna have a real good time here tonight.
Yeah.
And we got some old songs for you, some new songs, and some in-between songs. Okay? All right. Myself. It's been a long time since we've been able to get back on tour, so we're really happy to be here tonight playing for you. So that is the one and only wardrobe change of the whole evening. So, always put that little bit on the end of Let Me Roll It as a tribute to the late, great Jimi Hendrix. Yeah. And I tell the tale that I was very lucky to know Jimmy in the 60s in London, because even though he's American, he kind of broke out of London, you know. And we got to hang out a little bit together. He was a really nice guy, very, very humble, you know, fantastic guitar player. And he was new on the scene, so everyone wanted to catch him and see how he was playing, you know. And one of the greatest tributes he ever paid for us was that we had released Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band on the Friday night. We used to release records on the Friday. We released it on the Friday night, and 2 days later, on the Sunday, he'd learned it and he opened his show with it. And he did a great version of it, you know, it's a really wild version. And he had his vibrator arm, you know, this big speed, whammy bar, whatever you call it. And he was giving it some willy, you know, he was really going for it. And he's going, you know, giving it bow, bow, boom, 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 boom. And it was like a great solo. But those of us who knew about those Bixby vibrator arms, we knew that now he had to be wildly out of tune. Because you couldn't do that in those days, you know, you did everything would go if you gave it that much welly. So he's looking around, we're thinking, what's he going to do? It's his first number and he's totally out of tune. What's he going to do? So he starts looking in the audience and he's saying, is Eric out there, man? And he's looking for Eric Clapton. And Eric was in the audience, you know, everyone who was anyone was there. But Eric doesn't want to know. Eric's cringing down. Jimmy spots him. Says, hey man, so will you come up here and tune this thing for me? Eric says, no. Tune it yourself.
Yeah.
Thank you. Okay, this next song is one that I wrote for my wife, Nancy. And she's here in the audience with us tonight. This one's for you, Nance. What did it rain? We didn't care. She said that someday soon the sun was gonna shine. And she was right. This love of mine, my Valentine. As days and nights would pass me by, I tell myself that I was waiting for a sign, and she appeared, not so fine, a Valentine. I would love her for life. Well, we didn't care. She said that someday soon the sun was gone.
from our music school.
Thank you. So, I don't know if you can see the screen behind us, but that baby in my jacket has now got four kids of her own.
Yeah.
How time flies. Maybe I'll miss. Back to a little port in the north of England, a place called Liverpool. And in that little port, there were these four guys who got together, formed a band, and ended up doing quite well for themselves. But back then, it was a different state of affairs, because we're just a little gigging band, and you know, it was hard looking for work. So we decided that what we might do is we try and make a round, and we made the demo, and then the arrangement was that we each keep it for a week and then pass it to the next guy. So I kept it for a week and I passed it to John. He kept it for a week, passed it to George, who kept it for a week, passed it to Colin, who passed it to Duff, and Duff kept it for 20 years. And then he sold it back to us at quite a considerable profit. Anyway, the song that we did that day is the one we're going to do now. In spite of all the danger, but of all that may be, I'll do anything for you, anything you want me to. In spite of all the heartache that you may cause me, will I look after you like I've never done before? In spite of all that may be, oh, 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 I'll do anything for you, anything you want me to. Yeah. fighting for the heartache. Whoa, 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 whoa. Whoa, 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 whoa.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
Fighting for the danger. Fighting for the anything for you, anything you want me to. So we made that demo, and we tried to put it around, get people to listen to us, and eventually we got a record contract, and we were invited down to Abbey Road Studios in London. And we were recording with the great producer, George Martin. Let's hear it for George. So coming from the little studio in Liverpool to this big studio in London, it was kind of nerve-wracking. We'd never been in a big studio like that, you know. And we came in, you know, we were wondering what's going on. So anyway, George came in, and we were playing a song called Love Me Do for him. So, and John normally took the lead vocal. Love Me Do, and then he played harmonicas. Love Me Do, wah, wah, wah. George Martin, in the middle of the session, he said, Paul, he said, what he wanted was, he wanted the harmonica to come in on the one. Love Me, wah, wah. John couldn't do the both things. So George says to me, he said, Paul, will you sing the Love Me Do line? Now remember, I'm nervous, and I've never sung this line before in my life. So I go, yeah, okay. So I was nervous, now I'm terrified. And to this day, when I listen to the record on the radio, I can still hear that tremor in my voice. Love Me Do. Thank you. So we made Love Me Do, we made a few other records, and eventually came over to America. And that was a whole other different game. I mean, in England the girls would scream, but in America they scream, come on girls, let's have a Beatles scream.
Blackbird singing in the dead of night.
Yeah. Take peace on the lies and learn to see all your life. You're only waiting for this moment to be free. You're only waiting for this moment to be free. You were only waiting for this moment to be free. Thank you. I love about having written that song is I go around the world on tour. People come up to me and say, hey man, I tried to learn that Blackbird, you know? How many people here have tried to learn Blackbird? You all got it wrong. How it came about was we were seeing a lot of news coming from America in the 60s about civil rights. And down in the South, like in Alabama and Arkansas, Little Rock, we were seeing the segregation. And we didn't realize that went on, you know. We were kind of shocked. So I wanted to try and write a song that if it ever got back to those people going through those struggles, it might just give them a little bit of hope. You know, as the group got going, we were successful. We were together a lot. One of the things in those days that you couldn't really say, you know, a bunch of guys, the four guys, you couldn't really say, I love you, man. It just wasn't the dumb thing. Because you're all trying to be hard and be tough, you know. And so we never really got to say it, you know. We knew we all loved each other, but you could never say it. So I wrote this next song after John died. That's you for John. So I wrote this next song in the form of a letter that I never got to send. And if I said I really knew you well, what would your answer be? If you were here today, ooh, here today. Knowing you, you'd probably laugh and say that we were worlds apart. But as for me, I still remember how it was before. And I am holding back the tears no more. I love you. Ooh. Well, wonder by the time we met, hey, I really loved you and was glad you came along. That you were here today. Ooh. For you're in my song. Got someone you want to tell them you love them, just get it said, don't wait. And by the way, we know which songs you like. We can tell. Because like, when we do an old Beatles song, the place lights up with your phones. It's like a galaxy of stars. And then if we do a new song, it's like a black hole. But we don't care. We're gonna do them anyway. The lights.
Yeah.
Nice one. Tonight. Thank you. You having a good time? How about the people over here on this side? You having a good time? What about these people over here? From Boston. And then how many people not from Boston but from somewhere nearby? Now how many people not from Boston, not from somewhere nearby, but from somewhere completely different? The tourist board, we welcome you. Come on, baby, now. Let me look at you. Talk about yourself. Try to tell the truth. I could stay up half the night trying to crack your code. I could stay up half the night. Baby, now help me work it out. I won't let you down, so you don't need to shout. I can stay up half the night playing with your head. I can stay up half the night, but I'd rather go to bed. On the night, collection of ukuleles. Actually, you gave me this one, a Gibson. Very nice. And we were around at his house one day, and we were just jamming on the ukuleles, playing various songs. And I said to him, I've learned one of your songs on the ukulele. So we played it together that day, and we'd like to play it for you now. Something in the way she moves attracts me like no other lover. Something in the way she moves me, I don't want to leave her now. You know I believe her now. Somewhere in her smile she knows that I don't need no other lover. Something in a style that shows me I don't want to leave her now. You know I won't leave her now. Okay, now this next song, we're going to ask you to sing for us. In the middle of the song, I'll shout, "Now you!" And you will sing most gloriously for us. Yeah? Are you up for that?
Oh, yeah.
Do shows like this, a lot of people come along and they bring signs, put up these signs, and but what happens is you're trying to remember your words and the chords, and you're trying to sing it right, you're trying to concentrate, and your brain says, don't read the signs. Well, you do. There's the other half of your brain says, yeah, go on, it doesn't matter, really. So you do. Here we go, I've got it for you. Massachusetts loves you. Front, And this guy has been to our show 128 times. And we love it, man. It may be a little bit obsessive. No, I'm kidding, we love it. So anyway, listen, thank you for the signs. Happy early 80th birthday, who's that? We haven't performed ever live, never, until this tour. So this is the first one for Boston tonight.
Myself in times of trouble.